morning. Ira Epstein with your morning flash update. And we are now on Friday, the 27th of September, 2019, about 9:20 a.m. Central Daylight Time. What a week, right? Unbelievable. Impeachment proceedings. Now, today, a new thing. Oil prices, if you look, they went down rather hard. And that is because as soon as Iran's president got back, I guess, to Iran, he said that President Trump had offered to lift all sanctions if Iran would talk to them about ending all the problems that are going on, but the U.S. would lift them in front. Now, do you believe that in your wildest dream? Yet the market dropped $2. Now it's coming back because of the absurdity. You may think that would happen. I can't imagine it would happen. Stock market, looking at what's happening now with other parts of problems, and I'll show them to you in a minute. Metal markets, was today the final day of this washout? It's been coming down very hard. And we're down again in the nat gas. And people don't realize you've been down 8 days in a row. This could be the ninth day, and we haven't done something like that in, I don't know, maybe 15 years or so. So that's quite a drop. I'm not surprised. People don't seem to grasp the fact at times that you're at September 27th, you're not hot, you're not cold in the East Coast or the Midwest. I know our doors are open at home, the windows are open. I'm not burning natural gas, and that's important. So you build a little supply here. Let me get to you with what's important today. University of Michigan consumer sentiment. With all this craziness, and admittedly, this is taken just prior, of course, to the impeachment inquiry and all that's going on. But the consumer's not scared going into that. Their sentiment's 93.2. Prelim was 92. They expected 92. Current conditions, 108.5. September, 106.9. So that's not bad. 83.4 is the expectations part. The prelim was 82.4. None of that's bad. Where you get, okay, personal income up 0.4. That's what expected. But it's the consumption spending. It backed off a little bit. It's up 0.1. They expected it up 0.3. The core PCE index came out at 0.1. They expected it up 0.2. So that doesn't get the Fed on board. They're not worried about heating. They're getting concerned, if anything, slowdown. Month over month, PCE was unchanged. If you look at the PCE price index, it was up 1/8 more than the expectation. Then the durable goods came in up 0.2. They expected it down 0.1. Remember, durable goods last a longer time, 10 years and so on. So then ex-transportation up 0.5%. Well, the prior was down 0.4. I don't see all the weakness that people are getting nervous about, but the preliminary goods ex-defense, this was probably the number that scared some people, down 0.6. The last time was up 1.4. China Central Bank going into their big holiday saying that there are financial risks, that they are looking at what's going on, they feel they can contain it, blah, blah. And then, of course, this part, the Iran president said the U.S. offered to remove all sanctions against Iran in exchange for talks. President Trump was out instantly saying that didn't happen. And I believe him on that, and I think you should too. I want to remind you that, you know, I start you off each morning, good, bad, or ugly, with what's going on around the world. And from there, I start you with 45 charts. Now, there's going to be 40 futures, 5 ETFs. I do them by sections. Let's face it, to cover that many charts, no matter what I do, is going to take about 20 minutes. Not everybody has 20 minutes in the morning they want to go to, but you might say, hey, what stock indices doing? On the bar at the bottom, you just drag it. There'll be a bar that you pull, and it says stock indices, grains, metals, and they're always in a certain sequence. And on the side also of your screen, it mentions each of those categories. Click it, it'll take you right there like that. The idea here is to bring you up to date with that complex, what's going on in the world, where we're at, so on and so forth. And you get that right through all this as you get going with it. This will be the sequence. You can pull it, go whichever way you want. As I said, the idea here is to get you going with the fundamentals in the morning, to tell you what's going on, to give you ideas of trades, ideas not to trade from, so on and so forth. There is a charge for it. Getting up 4:30 in the morning to put this out. It's $7.95 for the first 30 days. No contract with us. You can go every month after that. And it's 30 days at a time. It's not month by month. You can even buy a full year ahead of time for $13 a month up front. You pay that, it's $156. If you think about it, a dollar in a gold, just gold, is $100. In the grains, $50 is what? A move. 1 cent. So this isn't a lot of money for what we're doing. The point is that the minimum tick covers your $7.95 as well in just about every commodity. How do you get it? Go to our website. You'll see on our new website the word research. Go under research, Ira's Morning subscriber video. You can click up here. It'll take you right there as well if you're watching me on YouTube. And of course, you can reach us the old-fashioned way that nobody does. Call us. You'll be shocked. We actually pick up the phone, talk to you, and get it done for you right away. I'm Ira Epstein. You have a great weekend, and I'll see you at the end of the day with our wrap-ups in all the different markets. Take care now.